This is Arvind Vohra, founder of Vohra Method and author of How to Get into an Ivy League College. And in this video, I'm going to show you an important technique for creating an extended analogy. An analogical reasoning, as we know, is a major way to demonstrate intelligence. You can show that you're thinking cleverly and in ways that are totally different from what other people are doing. And sometimes you use that to create a theme, sometimes you use that to create a backstory, but sometimes you just use that to cleverly explain a point using an extended analogy. It could be an extended simile or an extended metaphor. And here are the basic principles you want to stick with. The first part of the extended analogy, you want that, for the most part, you're probably going to want that to be a concrete thing where you're describing something specific and physical and visual that you can imagine and hold in your hand, not very, very abstract. The second half might be a little bit more abstract. The second half can also be concrete. Let's take an example. For this, I just basically picked bees and poetry. I just took two things at random. So here's notice the first half, it's going to be very, very concrete. The myth is that bees hop from flower to flower randomly collecting pollen. But in most subspecies of bees, each bee actually spends almost all of its time around one or two plants. The bee gets to know that plant, the nature of its secret pollen stores. For me, my fascination with poetry has been the same. I haven't read a particularly large number of poems. Rather, I've rediscovered the same poems. Yeats's gaze blank and pitiless as the sun has grown from the cold visage of a ringwraith to the endless wisdom of dragons to the stern paternalism of a Nordic king. So in the first half, what do? We set up the thing that we're going to be comparing it to. And we took a few sentences to do that. You can do that with an extended metaphor or an extended simile. And we just described something that was kind of specific and interesting. Even in the first half, we tried to have something unexpected. And then in the second half, we connected the abstract thing, the slightly more abstract thing, to that unexpected thing. So in the first phase, we have something unexpected and concrete, and then we extend that to something that's personal, something that's abstract, whatever. The key thing is you don't want either part to be expected. Even the concrete part, you want to be bringing in something that most people don't already know. Now, this fact I just made up, so I don't know if it's actually true or not, but you can find whatever you're talking about, you can find some fact that most people don't know. That's the starting point. That lets them know you're interesting. You're someone with clever ideas, and then you're going to show that you know more than just a few interesting bits of trivia, that you can make unexpected connection to either abstract or personal things.